Earlier today, I asked you guys on Snapchat to submit video questions that you'd like me to answer.
Hey Snapchat, I'm making a Q&A video, so submit your video questions and I will answer them.
Okay, so let's get started.
I have a question. What do you recommend for people who are not a morning people? Like, I need to wake up early, but like, what are your tips into waking up early? Because I'm not good at it.
So I know waking up early is really hard, but having good sleep hygiene can really help. So this means not having your phone, computer, or TV around bedtime and going to bed around the same time every day. Something that's helped me a lot is having an alarm clock that's also a lamp. So it starts to brighten your room about 30 minutes before you have to actually get up. So I'll put the link in the description box if you want to check it out. All these tips aside, I don't think I'll ever be a true morning person, but I will say that being excited for work and being at the hospital has made waking up early a lot easier.
Hi, my question for you is, when did you know you wanted to become a doctor? Was it bit by bit, or did you one day just came to a realization?
I realized that I wanted to become a doctor during my sophomore year in college when I took a neuroscience class. Originally, I wanted to do either psychology or music therapy, but after taking this class, I felt like studying medicine would give me so many more tools to help people.
Hello, my question is, how and when do you meal prep when you have such a busy school schedule? Thank you and God bless.
So I don't always get to meal prep these days, but I think the best time to meal prep is probably Sunday night before the week starts.
Amy, thank you for making your videos. I was wondering about breaks and how they work during medical school, and also does time allow for travel? Thank you so much.
At my school, you get a summer vacation after the first year of med school. So a lot of students that I know did some type of global health program so that they can get some clinical experience, but also get some traveling and at the same time. After second year, most people use their time off to study for step one and maybe take like 1 week off before starting third year. The amount of time that you have after second year really depends on how much time you want to give yourself to study for step one. During preclinical years of med school, you'll have time to take short weekend trips and maybe even longer trips if your lectures are not mandatory.
My question is, what rotation are you most excited about or interested in doing?
I'm probably most interested in my surgery rotation and emergency medicine rotation, but also OB-GYN and other stuff too. Pretty much everything is so new and interesting that I look forward to all of them.
Hi, I have a lot of anxiety and stress about school. Can you please give me some tips?
I think the best way to deal with stress and anxiety is to figure out the root cause of them. Are you anxious because you don't feel prepared for school, or is it for social reasons? If you feel like it's going to interfere with your day-to-day life, or if you feel like it's going to keep you from achieving your potential, it might be really helpful to talk to someone professional. There's going to be a lot of stressful situations in med school, and I think taking good care of yourself physically and mentally is really important. But also keep in mind, it's totally normal to feel nervous about new situations. I mean, I still get nervous being in the hospital sometimes. So I think some level of anxiety and stress is normal, and it can even be helpful.
Hi, Jamie. What's been your most favorite and least favorite part about becoming a doctor so far?
I think my favorite thing about being in med school is the whole process of this endless opportunity to better myself. You're constantly pushing yourself to learn more, do more, perform better, and you're always in an environment where you're being tested. So even if you're not competing against another person, you're always competing against yourself. I feel like I've learned so much and I've grown so much in the past 2 years, and it's been hard, but I'm really grateful for the experience. My least favorite thing about being in med school is that it can really limit the amount of time that you spend with your family and friends outside of med school. It's definitely a huge time commitment, and you tend to end up saying a lot of things like, oh, I can't, I have to study, and things like that.
Do you prefer making notes on your computer or written?
It definitely depends on the class. Majority of my notes from the first 2 years of med school were taken on the computer. But some classes like biochem or anatomy, I did more drawing or handwritten notes. If you want to find out more about how I took notes, I recently posted a video about it and you can check it out here.
What are the best things to major in when you're like pre-med in college?
So I don't think there's such thing as best major for pre-med. You'll likely have to take certain science classes regardless of your major to prepare for the MCAT. Academically, I don't think there's any particular major that you can that's gonna really prepare you for med school. I personally think it's best to major in whatever you're really interested in, whether that's science related or not.
Med school admissions frown upon a certain amount of credits taken at like a community college over the summer.
From my limited experience, most schools don't care much about where you took certain courses, but there are some schools that have requirements that say that you have to have taken some certain higher level courses at a four-year institution. So I think the best thing to do is to check with the individual schools that you're applying to. If you want to read more about other people's experiences, I'll post a link from Student Doctor Network Forum that talks about this topic. And that's usually a pretty good source to go for to see what other people have done.
Hey Jamie, I'm really young, but I want to be a doctor when I grow up. And for me, I was wondering what specialty you're interested in.
So I haven't really ruled out anything, but I am interested in emergency medicine and possibly surgery as a specialty.
My question is there any technique for reading from medical textbooks? Because I really don't know how or what is the best method to do that.
My experience with medical school textbook or medical textbooks is that I would look up certain things in the back of the book in the index and read about that topic. So I never really did a straight through reading of medical textbooks like a novel. So that's my technique for reading medical school textbooks.
If you didn't go to med school, what else would you be doing right now?
That's a really good question. I don't know. I'm actually not sure what I would be doing if I didn't go to med school. I'll have to get back to you on that.
Hey Jamie, can you walk us through the timeline of just studying in med school? Like, when are you gonna watch the lectures, take notes, and review them? Thank you, and I love your channel.
I actually have a video on my channel about my study schedule, so I'll link it right here. Right now, as a third year medical student, I pretty much study whenever I can, so like 10 minutes here and there at the hospital, or when I get home from the hospital and if I'm not too tired.
Hello, my question is, what specific technique do you study? Do you enjoy studying by yourself or do you supplement that with study groups?
I definitely did a mix of both. I mostly studied alone, but usually came together with my study group closer to the exam, and we would quiz each other and just be emotionally supporting of each other right before the exam.
Greetings from California. How do you make that perfect cup of coffee?
So I have to confess, my parents are huge coffee fans. They like roast their own beans and stuff. So I have a lot of coffee paraphernalia from them. I think my personal favorite way to make coffee is whatever that's the easiest. So I used to use my Nespresso machine a lot, and then my parents left their fully automatic espresso machine here with me, so that's what I've been using.
What would you say to someone who doesn't believe that they're good enough to go to medical school?
So I think believing in yourself and trusting yourself even in the face of failure is a really important quality in med school. Med school can be really challenging and there's going to be times when you doubt yourself and you feel like you're just not good enough. But you really have to fight through those moments of insecurity and no one's going to be able to do that for you. Only you can build yourself back up after making mistakes. And trust me, there will be lots of mistakes. Getting back up and learning from your mistakes is what's going to make you a great doctor. So that's it for the SnapTech Q&A session. I'm sorry if I missed your question this time around, but I'll be doing another Q&A session soon. So definitely let me know if you're submitting your question for the second time, and I will try to prioritize your question. I've made a playlist of all the past Q&A videos, so I'll link that below if you're interested. Thank you again. Give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye. this has been a very, very frequently requested video on how to take notes. So I've been compiling my ideas and have been taking notes, and I just want to share them with you guys.